What's up, guys? What is up? Someone ring the what's up horn. How's it going, guys? How's it going? God damn it. We find ourselves back in the ready room again. I don't feel so good, guys. I don't feel so good. But we'll worry about that another day. Right now, we're looking at helicopters PvP event round 9. Holy shit, son. We've done 9 of these. Fucking hell. So, we're going to have some PvP action, guys, in the helicopters. It's a big crowd tonight. I think it's going to be like 20 a side. 20 people on each side. So we have the Russia versus like the sort of the West. So we've got K50s and MI8s on the red side, and we have Gazelles on the blue side. Right now there's a lot of, you can hear engines and stuff flying around. That is just because the guys are all warming up, checking their comms and stuff like that, and just having a little bit of a play around, making sure that all their systems work and everything's hunky-dory. So on the blue side we've got Hueys, UH-1s, and Gazelle helicopters. Now the name of the game, guys, alright, now shout out to our man Alpenwolf, who sorts out all these events and we just host them for him, give him a place to run around in. But what we're going to see here, we're going to see two teams, the red team and the blue team. Both coalitions are operating from their own FARPs with 5 helipads each, and both sides are separated by approximately 40 kilometers. Now, there are 5 different zones, and we've named those zones Zone A, B, C, D, and E, and they can be captured and also recaptured. Now, the zones are marked, you're going to see them, they'll be marked by green smoke. Now, basically the aim in the game is for, you have to try and control all 5 zones, and the first team that can successfully do that or hold on to them for the end of the map is going to win. To capture a zone, you'll need to actually get one of your helicopters to come in and land and deploy troops within 250 metres of the green smoke. So this is going to be good fun to watch, guys. It's going to be a lot of fun to watch. So we're just allowing the guys to fly around and get all the tests and stuff done. I think that's about now. So I'm just going to check in with Alpenwolf to see if they're ready for the server to be restarted and we can get the show on the road. Are you ready to go? Hey, what's up, Master Chief Buster? Good to see you, dude. Good to see you. Welcome. Welcome. What's up, Gravy Navy? What's up, Gavin? Yeah, the server's on open beta, dude. It's that dinner making noises. No, bro. That was coffee making noises. I know you can see the ready room laundry. I'm a fucking trained professional, bro. You fucking tell me what you do, dude. I am a professional streamer, all right? I've only been wrong once in my life. Had sex with this guy when I thought it was a woman. It was an awkward moment. It was an awkward woman. But never mind. We'll talk about that another day. Right. So let's find out what Alpenwolf's saying. Where's my mouse? Where is my feckin' mouse? There it is. Restart. Yes, please. All right. So I'll bring the server down. Get myself out as well, and then I will relaunch the server so these guys can get back in and we'll get the show on the road. We will get the show on the road. Restarting.
Sound resumed. Sound muted.
Hey, English Adventurer, good to see you again, sir. Welcome. It's been a long time. It's been a long time. Welcome. Just bear with me, guys, while we get in this back in the server again. This is always the worst part of hosting these events, is sort of the nail biting, getting everybody in the server and praying that the server doesn't crash. I mean, we're on some really good hardware in the 104th. We actually have we built a physical machine and then shipped that off to a data center in America. So, I mean, we don't host our shit in someone's house or anything like that, or even in some office premises. We actually built a dedicated machine and shipped that out stateside. So we're packing some serious heat, is what I'm trying to say. We are packing some serious heat. My man Skipster, thanks for the re-up on the Prime, sir. Thank you very much. The Prime time for 9 months. Skipster DC, welcome on board. Good to see you, dude. What's up, Yambo? Welcome. It should be fun indeed, buddy. It should be fun. Why is Haggis in the front row? Does he need to help? Haggis in the front row because Haggis is the wind beneath my wings, bro. All right? I wouldn't be able to do any of this crap if it wasn't for Haggis. Haggis is the man that makes all this possible. I just look at the camera and shout and scream. He actually makes all this stuff happen. What's up, El Gargantuan? Good to see you, dude. Thank you very much. Holy shit, bro. The resub on the Prime for 2 months. Thank you very much, sir. Welcome along. Alright, I am feeling a little bit under the weather. Guys. I think I'm coming down with a cold. Don't worry, I don't have any fever or anything like that. You guys are not going to get sick by watching the stream. But yeah, total disclosure, guys. I don't feel fantastic.
X104TH Scottish Mav X104TH Scottish Mav X104TH Scottish Mav X104TH Coffee.
Don't mind if I do. I don't know, bro. I'm actually starting to think, fuck it, let's just go out and get infected, alright? The sooner I get sick, the sooner I get better, and I just don't have to fucking stress out about it, because the way things are looking, it looks like everyone's going to end up getting this at some point. Right, anyway, we'll talk about the COVID scare another day, no worries. Started to get the courage to flying on our public server. Nice, brother, nice. Yeah, if you need any information about the missions or anything like that, get yourself on, just go to Google and type in 104 Phoenix. And help yourself over to our website, and if you check out our forums, we have loads of stuff for mission briefings and stuff like that, information about the server, the TeamSpeak server and stuff, yada yada yada. I will put a link in the chat for you guys now. Oh, just quickly while we're getting the event started, guys, we have rescheduled DCS Top Gun Viper Sniper. So that is now going to be on the weekend of the 11th and 12th of April. So if you're an aspiring F-16 pilot that loves his guns only action, click on that forum link for ED Forums and get yourself signed up on the sign up thread there. And yeah, come and show us your mad skills, bro. Viper Sniper coming at you next month, guys. Next month, look out for it. All right, so let's go with the DCS capture now. Put myself down here, hide in the corner. Nobody puts baby in the corner. Never mind any of that crap. Right, so this is where we're going to be conducting our main business from. We have the blue side up here in the northeast corner of the map, and we have the red side starting down in the southwest corner. Now we can see that there are five different zones: Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta, and Echo. And like I said, how both teams are trying to capture control of these zones, and how they do that is by landing a transport helicopter down there and deploying troops. So both sides have an attack helicopter and a transport helicopter. So for Team Stalin, representing the Putin power, we have the Ka-50s as attack helicopters and the Mi-8s as the transport helicopters. And these guys can pack some serious heat as well. They actually can carry guns and stuff like that. Now, this is a guns-only event, guys. We're running with a guns-only theme this month and next month. For a little bit. So there's going to be no missiles. No missiles allowed for the Gazelles or the K-50. So it's going to be an interesting one, guys. A real interesting one. A lot of FARP action down here. So I'll show you quickly who's on board. So look at how many helicopter aircraft we have here, guys. God damn, Alpenwolf's done a great job getting all this set up. So everybody's getting spooled up and getting their engines all ready and all jazzed up. I am just a commentator as far as I'm aware. I don't think I'm serving as the event referee, so I'm just going to check that to make sure they're not waiting on me to call start or anything like that. Are you going to call start, or do I have to do it? And up on the blue side, we have the UH-1H as the transport helicopters, and we have the Gazelle as the attack helicopters. So again, A lot of brothers up here for the blue side. What we'll do is we'll just quickly have a look and I'll show you who is who. Who's who in the zoo? So, Commie's going to be doing the fighter control for the blue side. On the red side, so these are the K-50 pilots. On the red side, we have Yambo, Eons, Requiem, Wizard, Bogar, Board, Wyan, Dutch, Shadow, Cafartes, Yukon, Pups, Frosty, RF21939, that guy needs a better name, Crash, Grizzly, Chugga682, Night Stalker, and Brown Floyd. So from Yukon down, that's the MI8 pilots. And then for the blue side, we have Pitbull Vicious, NeoCB, /Chris. Could probably do a better name there, bro. Do we really need /Chris in there? I'm not sure. I'm not judging him. The man, the myth, the legend, Octopal Fire. We have Tommy, Impact Tiger. Oh, Impact, we have Tiger. Oh, Christ. Tiger. Oh, what is the name? So, never mind. All right, I'll go for the top again. Alpha Fox Alpha, Quad G, Bullet, Silent Gun, Night Stalker, Thompson, Feral Cat, Mago, that's not Magoo because there's only one O in it, Mago, Tiger, Tommy, my man Chris again, Camino, Octopal Fire, Impact, and Pitbull Vicious. So a pretty even spread, guys. Let's have a quick look at the set. So 18 versus 18 now. Technically it's 17 versus 18 because I am, in fact we're still getting some people in. There's the man, the myth, the legend, the Bob Ross of DCS. Hera Missy's joining us, guys. He will also be streaming as well, so make sure you jump onto Missy's stream, check out the action from his cockpit view. I'm sure you guys are going to enjoy that. What am I looking for? I'm looking for this. Right, so, yes, me buddy. Right, so Alpenwolf's actually going to call the start, so I've removed myself from the responsibility circle. And I don't have to do anything. Oh dear. Look at this. Really, bro? Really? What's going on? What the f- I am not too sure about that, guys. I'm not too sure about what sort of physics we've got on. Somebody get me Wags on the phone! Fuck's sake. Right, let's get back over to the Russian brothers. So I'm trying to find a... I'm just trying to work out where I'm going to watch everybody take off from. I think this will be quite a cool spot. Because all the... I think all the blues have to take off and turn around versus the reds, which are just apart and straight into the... Oh, what's happening here? There we go. So yeah, we'll just chill out here, guys, and we'll see everybody depart. But yeah, again, just to reiterate, this is going to be guns only. So this is going to be chaos, absolute chaos. I think the Gazelle L, we don't have any Mistrals in, obviously, because it is guns only. So it's just the Gazelle L that we have in. Now, one of the men to watch out for is good old Octopal Fire here. This guy's an absolute machine in these Gazelles. So he's going to be one of the main protagonists, I'm prophesizing. I think everybody only has one life. This is terrible, dude. I'm the fucking event coordinator. I don't even know the fucking rules. Hold on a second. Let me just quickly check to see how many lives they get. I'll tell you what. We'll post the rules in the chat so you guys can see as well. You guys can read along. Oh, character limit. Oh, never mind. Not going to be able to do that. You can check out the post if you want, guys. Check this out. You can read about the rules and you can see the map and stuff like that that we're working with. Alright, he hasn't actually put... Oh, here we go. No, he hasn't. He hasn't actually put the rules up for how many lives the guys get, so I'm going to drag his ass in here and quickly ask him.
Sound resumed.
Where is he? Ah, maybe not drag him out, that might be rude. Is he talking? Check if he's talking. He is talking, so I'm going to type to him instead. How many lives does each bro get? Check out my Wild Weasel swag, guys. Hashtag Tomcat love. Loving it! Loving it! He's doing his brief right now, English. He's doing his, he's actually the GCI for the red side, so I've checked to see if he is, there he is there. Hold on a second. User was moved to your bro, you're live on stream, please don't say fucker bugger.
Roger that.
How many lives does each pilot get?
MI8s and UH1s, 4 lives each. K50s and Gazelles, 3 lives each.
Roger, roger. Looks like we're taking off now and we're getting started, yeah?
Yep.
Awesome.
There we go.
All right, good luck, sir.
Good luck, sir.
Holy fuck, this is awesome. Some early gun rounds coming out. I hope we're not going to have any friendly fire incidents, but holy shit, guys. Like half a fucking Air Force getting any action here. Looking good. Can you move yourself down or do you need me to move you out?
Sorry?
Can you move out of this channel or do you need me to do it?
I can move.
Alright, we're on board with Octopal Fire. He's on his way in. Looks like he is yet. So confirmed in the L version. Has he got some rockets on the side there? I'm not sure. Maybe they're... Definitely not missiles anyway. Definitely doesn't have missiles. Possibly some unguided rockets on there. So yeah, a mass exodus by both teams here. So like the man says, so the transport pilots have 2 lives and the attack pilots have 1 life. I use TrackIR, bro. So it looks like the red side electing to go and possibly splinter up into 2 different groups here. We have the sort of the main package here with a lot of heavy hitters in the front here. We've got my man Yambo. Who else have we? Ross Pups, another veteran of the Red Flag events. The guys from the Ugly Squadron. The man, the myth, the legend, Wizard. I love this guy. When he's not on the Heapler section of the forums bitching about stuff, I love this guy. He's electing to go in with the gear down for some reasons. I think he's just thinking ahead about safety, guys. That's all. In case he's looking at some sort of engine failure, doesn't want to have to risk having to put the gear down. Here's my man Shadow leading the pack at the front with another K50 flying line abreast, slightly in trail. Looks like we're up some nice autumn colours here, guys, in the in southern Russia. Ah, I love the smell of southern Russia in the evening. So it looks like those guys are going straight for this. I think this is Objective Echo. Let's have a quick look. It is indeed Zone Echo. So they're heading straight towards that to try and secure. Looks like the blue side are... I mean, this is pretty expected, guys. This is pretty predictable that the blue side are all departing. They're trying to get to their closest objectives. And the red side are trying to get to their close objectives. Looks like our man looks like our man Kafartes. I'm not sure. Somebody help me out with this. Someone help me with some words here. I can see the letters and stuff, but they just need to make sense. So it looks like he's going up there to maybe try and defend Alpha, Bravo and Charlie. We have Bullseye right in the middle here, but definitely the red side are more leaning to the southeast side of the objectives, and the blue side are, looks like they're targeting the northwest side. So yeah, possibly a lot of shenanigans going to be going down at around about the Bullseye point, guys. Another bro coming up behind him somewhere. There he is. Is there fuel tanks on that guy? Bro. So you can see all the green smoke coming up from the objectives. This is where the transport helicopter pilots, they need to land in those zones and deploy their troops. So their team can actually capture the objectives. Now, it looks like it is going to go down just in a roundabout this area. This is Objective Alpha, Bravo and Charlie. So it looks like most of the action, certainly the early action, is going to be going down around about Bullseye in between Bravo and Charlie. Kafartes and Dutch heading a little bit more up to the north. We've got Boger, Yambo, Wizard and Eons trapping up in the middle. Looks like we've got a little contingent in the back there, nice and sensible. These guys not rushing in. The man, the myth, the legend. 51st Frosty's in here representing Flying MIA. I love this guy. Hopefully we're going to see him have a good event. So it looks like the first people that are going to get to where they should be going is Team Red, guys. The Red Russians are going to get to where they're supposed to be going first. So I think it's going to be my man RF21939. Not the most charismatic call sign that you've ever heard, but I'm sure this guy knows what he's doing. So be heading straight for the green smoke. We should be able to see that somewhere in front of us. This is just over this hill here. Or is the smoke all stopped? No, I can still see smoke on the left there. Ah, oh, there it is there, it's just a little piddly smoke. So the K50's first, just securing the area, getting in, clearing the way, ploughing the road! So we should see the MI8 going to be coming into land pretty soon as well now. I want to just stay, I know seeing the transport guys is pretty cool, but this is dangerous here. Alpha Fox Alpha and Feral Cat, both YOLOing in straight in front of Boger. They don't have any gazelles protecting them. This guy's definitely sorted on them, they're right in front of them. The Hueys do have guns to defend themselves, they're already coming out. He's already firing at them. I think that might be the door gunners actually having a go. Oh, this is awesome, bro. This is awesome. This K50's in big trouble, guys. So the first Huey's down. He's going to get his troops out and try and get in the fight. Boger is just totally YOLO'd right past both of them. Doesn't seem to be too interested in engaging anyone. Now he's coming back round. He might just be trying to stay. Nimble. Do you know what I mean? Just trying to keep bobbing and weaving so that they can't get decent shots on him. Yambo's going to come in though and put this. He's going to take. Surely Yambo's going to take some. There we go. Yambo's going to try and take a little taste. He elects to just totally ignore the ground troops that were deployed on the ground and go straight for the enemy. Don't let this happen, bro. Jesus Christ. Don't let it happen, Yambo. Watch those squirrels, sir. As we all know, guys, the Squirrel Nation are the most powerful players in DCS. You get too close to those trees, they'll jump out and grab you. So they're going to play Ring Around a Rosie for a little while they work that out and try and shoot at each other. No blues pushing on Objective Delta right now. Looks like it is all going to be going down across Bullseye. Camino getting a little bit isolated here. He's got Dutch and Cafartes. Looks like they're going in for a little Russian sandwich here with Camino as the meat. So Objective Charlie looks under blue control. Impact Silent Gun, Tommy Nightstalker, Mago and Pitbull Vicious all supporting, just hanging out to the east. Yambo elects to get out of there, thinks better of it. But yeah, Camino's in big trouble here. He's got Dutch in the back and Cafarty's right off the nose. I don't think, does Dutch see him? There you see, I don't think Dutch sees him, dude. Look how low he is. Look, he's right down there, brothers and sisters. Fucking hell. This guy does not see him. Surely he should see these fucking rounds, though. His wingman must be screaming, "Bro, he's right in front of you!" Oh, Camino! Camino's making it happen! Absolutely making it happen! That's some good hits there! Some great hits! This K50's in big trouble, dude! He's already on fire! And not in the good way! And Dutch just has no idea what's going on. He's completely missed the whole instigation process of the fight. My man Camino was outnumbered 2 versus 1. He's got a Huey coming into the rescue now. With those pilot-directed miniguns right off the nose there. Putting some more hits into Camino. Who was that? That was Cafartes. Yeah, so Dutch and Cafartes in big trouble, guys. So Gazelle and Huey are passed around the back. So there's not really any forward issues for this guy. Looks like he may be sorted on Hera Missy. This is a dangerous job. Missy's a trained professional, guys. And I know he's got the skills to pay the bills. Missy will also be streaming as well, folks, if you want to hop onto his stream and check him out. You can see what the event looks like from his point of view. I think we're going to stick with this, guys. This looks like the best action's going to be right in front of us. Here we are on board with Camino. He's looking to just line up his nose here, get some good nose authority, get some shots out. Needs to be careful he doesn't start drifting back down towards the ground. K50's got the angels on. Holy shit, bro! He just absolutely wrecked his fucking main rotor. That is some serious issues, bro. We sort of need that. We sort of need that, and he is going down, dude. He is going down, brothers and sisters. Get out, sir. Think of your family. Think of your family. Is he going to be able to auto-rotate? Some sort of recovery. Ah, and he's down. He is down. We've seen our first kill on stream, guys. So that's good for Team Blue. Not so good for Team Red. We have a Night Stalker looking to put in a little ambush. Frosty's on the ground, and he's just unloaded his troops. A trained professional is young Frosty here. Representing the Welsh. I think all the troops are shitting it and trying to get back in the helicopter. Frosty says, "Hell no, bro. This ain't no fucking train ride, son. Get out there and secure that LZ." So Frosty gets back in the air, possibly going back to get some more troops or just get his guns. You got to be in it to win it, guys. Here we have Havco facing off against Board 046. Pippy, pippy, pap, pap, pip. And it looks like Board's got some good shots. Unfortunately, the tail roar and then the main roar departs as well, sir. I am sorry, my friend. Unfortunately, there's no option for the Huey pilots to eject. The only people that are going to be able to eject are the K-50 pilots. Requiem here is in all sorts of shit. Looks like he's just shot down someone right off the nose, but he has the man, the myth, the legend, Taut Impact, coming up on his six, and he is not manoeuvring fast enough, and now fuel's coming out. Bits are falling off the fucking aircraft. It's going wrong, sir. Get out of there. Eject, son, eject. Think of your family. Another K50 trying to come to the rescue. Takes a main roar off that gazelle. And I'm afraid you need that shit, sir. He is checking out of there, unfortunately. But the K50 is Russia strong, bro. He's leaking fuel. Half the aircraft's missing. And he is okay. I think he's going to be able to make it back to base. Shadow coming in. Just maybe try and force Pitbull Vicious. Those are words. Pitbull Vicious off the objective there. The blue troops are still on the ground there, though. Frosty kicking back towards Bullseye. I wonder if any of these guys are going to start thinking about doing gun runs. Gun runs on the actual enemy infantry that are on the ground. Because these positions, just to reiterate, can be captured and recaptured. So if you come in and destroy all the enemy ground troops that are on the ground and then you land your bros down there, then you're in it to win it, guys. That is all good for you. So Night Stalker needs to be careful here. He's outnumbered 3-1, although we know our man Requiem is missing half an aircraft, so he's probably not going to be much of a factor. Frosty is balls deep on his own here. Wizard's very deep as well up in the north. He's just going in on his own. He needs to be careful. He's got the man, the myth, the legend, Bullet sorting on him. Octopal Fire as well. Camino and Missy. This is not looking good for my man Wizard. Let's see if is Yambo actually attacking any of those ground troops? See, we can see the blue ground troops down there. I'll zoom in. See them moving around down there, guys. They're actually aiming at Yambo, maybe trying to shoot him. That is awesome. So Yambo has got support in the back. And he's trying to take some shots at Night Stalker. Some long range shots coming in there. Here's Bullet. I'm hoping to see Bullet. Yeah, Bullet's door gunners. Bullet will also be streaming this as well. Guys, if you want to get on Bullet streaming, check him out. So Bullet's door gunners just going to town. I think they're all called Jeff. No association with the JF-17. I think just all those guys are called Jeff anyway. So Bullet with a nice little aggressor skin on. I like this. So he's going to come around for another pass. He's going to get his door gunner. So he's taking hits. He needs to be careful here because these infantry guys do fire back. He's coming in with the pilot mounted guns. No mercy. Holy shit. Every single round missed. I take that back. We killed one guy. We killed one guy. It's a job well done. So Bullet's in it to win it. He's got his eyes on the prize and he's starting to do some strafing runs. I think we need some more blue aircraft coming down to back him up though and help him out. We don't have any air-to-air action on right now, guys. Both sides are just sort of feeling themselves out. Frosty looking to go into the merge with the Stalin bus on the man, the myth, the legend Bullet. This is going to be interesting. Holy shit, he brings the pain. Holy shit, bro, that's like a fucking lightsaber. Oh, dude, he over-G'd the aircraft and it fell apart. Ah, oh, bro, they don't make them like they used to. They do not make them like they used to, I'm afraid. Oh, God damn it, Frosty. I'm sorry, brother. Poor Frosty, guys. His story will be told. His story will be told. So that's a maneuver kill for Bullet. He can safely claim that with some good confidence. I'll drink to that. Right, so Bullet's going to keep his eyes on the prize. He's got Octopal Fire coming to back him up now to start bringing the pain on these ground units. Octopal does have a cannon, so he can open up. He needs to get Tally Visual on them first, though. We can see them right in front of him. Should be some good opportunities for him to get some hits here. Pippy, pippy, pat, pat, pip. That's what we need to do, guys. There he goes. Pip, pip, pippy, pip, 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 pippy. Good man. Octopal Fire absolutely deadly in his little gazelle aircraft. He's been the star of the show many times before in these helicopter events. Guy really knows what he's doing. It's always a pleasure to watch him handle his business as well. Right, so we have Board 046 maybe thinking about taking on these guys on his own, which I think is really his only option. We have Cathartes or Cathartes or Cathartes. Fucking someone help me out with that goddamn name, guys. Yeah, he looks like he's the only one in a position to kind of help him out. These other, or maybe they're just regrouping. I'm not sure what's going on here. They are all on channel with each other. And again, to reiterate, guys, they all have human fighter controllers. So both sides have a human person, just like me and you, that are watching. Basically, they can see essentially what we can see on this screen here. And they're using the ruler tool, which is this one up here, to basically tell the people to say, hey, Yambo, you have an enemy gazelle bearing 353 for 5 miles at 4,000 feet, flanking, hostile. All right, here we have a two ship of Feral Cat and Silent Gun, two Hueys on the creep. There's Silent Gun, there's Feral up in front of us. They're using the dead ground on the way in, that's very sensible. Trying to stay low off the enemy's radar coverage. Because if the enemy radar doesn't see you, then the enemy fighter control doesn't see you. At least in theory, that's how it should work. DCS can be a little bit meh when it comes to that from time to time. But Octopal Fire looks like he is on patrol. And it looks like the blue side have successfully eliminated all the red units in this objective, guys. And now they've got their own bros on the ground. That is a major win. Major, major win. Hopefully there's not going to be any confusion. And Octopal Fire lights up some friendly troops. But look, we've got our man Harley Nick touching down. Put her down, son. You can do it. He's going to get his ground troops deployed. Troops are on the ground. TIC, bro. Well, that's not true. Troops on the ground. That's boots on the ground. TIC is troops in contact, as I'm sure you're all aware. All right, Yambo and Shadow looking to just try and get in there. Do a bit of flexing. Just get in there and say, hey, you guys can't have it all your own way. We're coming. We are coming. So Yambo looks like he's going to go toe-to-toe with Bullet. Shadow looks like he might want to just flank a little bit, possibly be chasing after Octopal Fire. I don't think Yambo sees Bullet. Bullet on the old flank 1-6. Bullet's door gunners really should be engaging this K-50 by now, unless he's got them on hold. But yeah, Yambo definitely doesn't see him. Yambo is just YOLOing straight past him. Listen to that sound, bro. Looked like a jet in front of us there, but there's a... Dude, some fucking crazy long-range shots. Some wildly ambitious fucking shots there, Yambo. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love him. But yeah, come on, son. Alright, Yambo looks like he is sorting on Harley, and he's got Octopal Fire bearing down on him. Octopal looks 100% sorted. Oh, this is deadly. This is very deadly for Yambo. Yambo does not see Octopal, but Octopal is totally sorted on him. He's going to get some pippy pippy pap pap pips out. Uh-oh. Mid-air. Mid-air collision, guys! Oh, Yambo's okay, though! This guy, dude, this fucking guy would fall off a boat into a river and come out dry. Remember in the MiG-21 event that we had, like, last weekend, the guy was flying half an aircraft? The guy just has the fucking Putin power, bro. This cave, this Huey is just giving him everything. He's got another Gazelle chasing him down on the back. But yeah, the Russians know how to make some sturdy stuff, guys. Holy shit, dude. He's popping out flares. That's not to try and defeat any weapons. That's just to say, help, bro! Help, I'm flaring! Help, motherfucker, they're coming to get me! Alright, so Yambo's going to get ran down. I think the K-50's a little bit faster than both these aircraft, actually, so he might be able to get out of there. Shadow is going... I was going to say balls deep. He's actually going home, bro. Shadow's actually really safe. Never mind. He's going towards the red base, Maverick. Not the blue base, you've fucking been... Right, so Red are still firmly holding on to Objective Echo. No one's landed at Objective Delta yet. Charlie is also vacant. We have Bravo and Alpha. Both have blue troops. So at the moment, the blue side very much in the driving seat. Red side are looking a little bit scattered, guys. Red side looking a little bit scattered. I think Yambo might actually be streaming as well. I'm not 100% sure, guys. Click back on the DCS page and check out which guys are streaming. You will be able to see. So Heremissi is definitely streaming. Bullet streaming. And I don't see Yambo. Unfortunately, I think that might be it, guys. Oh, Impact streaming, but he's on the blue side as well. So quite a lot of options, guys. Quite a lot of options. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like there's any red pilots that are streaming, I'm afraid. All right, Shadow looks like he isn't sorted on it. He doesn't see this ugly angel pilot. Who has crash landed. Looks like he's lost his tail rotor, but he's a trained professional and he worked that out, sir. Fucking great job. So he'll get back in it. He'll get back up. He'll turn that frown upside down, but it looks like he has been shot down. Bullet needs to be a bit careful. He's got Dutch moving in on the 6. Shadow and Boger. Both, in pursuit of Harley. Yambo is still alive. This guy, bro. Invincible. Alright, Bullet low with the squirrels. Bullet is in a target-rich environment, guys. Here we have a K-50 just up in front of us. Looks like he's queuing up on one of Bullet's wingmen. He is going to merge with him. And the other K-50's took off half that rotor. He is going down, bro. That main rotor is checking out, dude. I'm sorry, sir, but you need that.
Enemy helicopter spotted.
So we've got two enemy helicopters right off the nose. Bullets in big trouble. It looks like they're both coming straight back for him as well. In fact, the one on the left might be firing away. Bullet elects to open up early. Accuracy by volume. He does take a little taste. And there's some more. K50 driver tries to put on the brakes real hard. I'm not sure if that was the right decision. Bullet's just struggling for nose authority. Doesn't want to pull too hard. I guess we might lose some bits of air care. So this is Bullet sorting on Boger, who has Dutch coming to the rescue. Needs to be careful with this maneuver. This could end badly. Some good hits though. Some great hits. Oh, dude. That K50's got like Swiss cheese and almost another mid-air, guys. Almost another mid-air. Bullet with a great recovery. He's going to roll out and pull out. That's that K50 just shrugs it all off and goes, ha 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 ha. What else have you got, bro? What else have you got? You're going to have to do better than that. Oh, shit. Actually, it looks like he might be in a bit of trouble. Oh, no, bro. That looks bad. And again, just the K50 just soaking it up, bro. Just soaking it up. Holy shit, dude. That was a lot of fucking... That was a lot of lead went into that aircraft there. And he's still flying, bro. That looks bad. Watch the tree. Watch the squirrels, bro. Squirrel Nation will get you, dude. Squirrel Nation will get you. Bullet is not going to let him get away. This other K50's wingman is not doing a good job at this mutual support malarkey. Oh, no. Just as I say that, his wingman comes in and saves him. Ah, Bullet. I am sorry, sir, but you need that main roar. He's just going to stay on the trigger and hopefully maybe take someone with him.
Negatory.
I'm afraid that is not going to work out, sir. So Boger was saved, absolutely saved by Dutch and Wizard that came into the rescue here. All right, so Night Stalker, Tommy and Thompson now trying to put a little bit of pressure on these guys. Holy fuck, Feral and Taw Impact. We've just lost Feral. We got a Feral down. Taw Impact is still merged with 900 bandits. He's got some good altitude though. He may be able to escape from here. I don't think anybody's shooting at us right now. This would be a good aircraft to start coming down and put some rounds on. This MI-8 that's just landed there. That's an easy target. The altitude right now is saving him. Everyone else is down low. He has got a K-50 right off his nose. I don't think he sees that guy. That K-50's just lost his main rotor. At least the edges of it. And stuff's getting bad. Stuff's getting real bad. Get out, sir. Think of your family. God damn it. Didn't think of the family, guys. Alright, so Taw Impact is still alive, wheeling and dealing. He has a friendly aircraft. Two behind him. We have Crash, who I don't think is sorted on him. He's down low. So Impact is above a lot of people, guys. And what is that? That's a K-50 that's coming up to try and meet him. I've seen some bits falling off the aircraft there. So Taw needs to start wheeling and dealing here, my man. Impact needs to turn this frown upside down. And he is trying to turn into the threat. I don't think he sees where the threat's coming from, though. He's sort of higgledy-piggledy all over the place. He's doing a salmon right now. We've got some more stuff leaving the aircraft. Get your fucking sandwiches out, sir. Oh, bro, there goes the tail section. That is no bueno.
Negatory.
God damn it. And he's checking out, guys. We don't need to see that. We don't need to see that. All right, so down he goes. And we got Night Stalker trying to chase down Brown, Floyd, and Grizzly, who look like they're trying to escape to or maybe trying to go offensive on the guys that are up here. It's all happening, guys. We have Tommy merged with Dutch, Wizard, and Frosty. Frosty looks like he's going to get some rounds off the aircraft now, and Tommy takes it to the face. Unfortunately, Tommy's no longer with us, guys. Tommy is no longer with us. Rest in peace, bro. Rest in peace. Your story will be told. Here we got a nice little multi-ship merge going on here. Stuff's happening. Door gunners are getting in it. FPS is not a thing right now, guys. Holy shit, we're smoking bad. Just guns blazing everywhere, folks. Just carnage. My man Crash is on fire. And not in a good way. Possibly going down. Definitely going down, bro. Some serious casualties coming in, guys. Some serious casualties. Night Stalker getting the side door gunners in it to win it. I think they might be engaging ground. No, he's trying to just finish off a helicopter there. Bro, forget the guy that's on the ground. Shoot the bros that are still in the air. Get this guy. Does he have any forward-mounted guns? Yes, he does. They're sort of aiming a little bit too low at the moment, though. He's working on some trim issues. Come on, bro. We need to reset that trim and get that rudder moving. Let's start pressing some fucking pedals, sir. The Stalin bus is trying to make a run for it. It looks like he has backup. We have a K-50 engaging us in the rear. In fact, this is a fucking MI-8 coming to the rescue, guys. This might even be Frosty in the back. Night Stalker's in big trouble. He needs to get this guy killed fast as he can. The MI-8's getting away, though. Some long-range shots, brother. I'm not sure if that's going to... And he's in big trouble from the back, bro. Big trouble from the back. He's not paid enough attention to what's going on, sir. Right behind you!
Enemy helicopter spotted!
God damn it, that main rotor is checking out, sir. Oh, Night Stalker. I'm sorry this happened to you, bro. He is no more. He is no more, brothers and sisters. Alright, so a massive... My man Thompson is in deep shit here. But here comes Missy! Here comes Missy, the man, the myth, the legend. Get in there, Missy! Holy shit, he's got no idea who he even sort on. There's so many fucking enemy aircraft. It's just like that fucking scene from Iron Man 2 where it's fucking, they're fighting all the, fucking never mind that analogy. Let's get back in here. What's he doing? Right, so let's get him, bro. Shoot him. Side door gunners getting in some good hits from the side door gunners. Missy needs to keep his head on a swivel though. There's so many aircraft around him. He's just engaging as many people as he can. A busy day to be a side door gunner, guys. A busy day. Baptism of fire. So he might be trying to run down Eons. Eons is getting a little bit separated. It looks like the rest of the package has peeled off. I don't think Missy sees Eons, actually. No, it looks like Eons is going to escape. He's going to do the old sneak 1-6 and get out of here. Holy shit, dude. There's going to be a lot of little holes in the ground after this. Octopal fire going head to head with Wizard. This should be a good one. Two very talented pilots. Great hit. See that the first fucking round connected, bro. That's how good a shot this guy is with that. This guy's in big trouble. Wizard is in big trouble. Some great patience shown by Octopal Fire there to not get too greedy and start firing too early. And he's took him down, dude. He's make it count. Look at that. Didn't need to fucking fire 150 rounds. Just was patient, showed great discipline, and waited until he had a good weapon solution and fired. What a way to show it how it's done, sir. Well done. Alright, we have the reinforcements coming out from the blue side after either respawning or heading back up to rearm and refuel. Shadow looks like he's trying to run down Mr. Missy. How dare you, sir? You can't hurt Mr. Missy. He's fucking the Bob Ross of DCS, bro. I think Octopal Fire is going to try and turn that frown upside down. He's not going to let this happen on his watch. Oh, something crashed. Missy crashed! What the fuck? Oh, that must have been Shadow taking him down. Fuck no!
Negatory.
God damn it. Alright, Octopal. This guy has to fucking pay, bro. Has to fucking pay. You think he can fucking just roll up and shoot Bob Ross and get away with it? Hell no. Alright, Requiem looking to maybe mop up some ground bros here. A lot of aircraft parts lying on the deck here. Shit got real over here, guys. Shit got really real. Are these ground units going to engage this guy? I can see a bro standing next to the green smoke here. Yes, look at this dude. The little guy's engaging us. I love this guy. The Queen's going to start. Oh, what? That killed him. Ah, bro. Oh well. He tried, guys. Shout out to whoever that guy was. That little guy. Press F in the chat to pay respects to that little soldier, guys. Come on, let's get those Fs in. F in the chat, please, guys. Let's go. Here we have Mago and Wyan in the merge. What a brave little soldier. Alright, Mago, definitely in the driving seat. K-50 driver's in big trouble. Some great hits. We'll look at another K-50 trying to support this guy. We've got some hits coming in the Gazelle, bro. You need to make this fast. We're in big trouble, dude. Someone else is shooting at us, brother. Oh, no. He's going down, dude. He is going down. Checking out. Auto-rotation. Nope. Auto-rotation denied. All right. Blade's going to come in and try and get some revenge. So Blade's going to put the rounds in. Yes. There goes the back end of that K-50. Get out of there, sir. Think of your family. Oh, he's dead. Not a lot of people thinking about families, guys. I mean, even if you're not married, even if you don't have any kids, what about your mum and dad? What about your fucking cousins and your granny and that? Do you know what I mean? Think of your family, guys. Blade with a great little switch. A little switch blade. See what I did there? K50 pilot Lexigo High, nice sensible decision, especially in a gunfight with another helicopter. Altitude really is the almost the be all and end all. Anytime he has to put his nose up, he's going to start going down, so. Both drivers just struggling with the flight models a little bit, just to try and get the nose pointing where they need it to point. Blade doing a great job at keeping his nose pointed near where it should be. Holy shit, dude. Holy fuck. Oh, that doesn't look good. Is he going to recover that? He is going to recover that. God damn it, some fucking... The guy's showing us how it should be done out here. Kind of. Both drivers did a great job, though. Both drivers did a great job. There'll be a bit of panic that's going on here, guys. Both guys will be sweating a little bit. It'll be sweaty hand time in the back of these cockpits. Alright, we've swapped positions now in terms of... Oh, shit, dude. That's about as close as it comes to a mid-air without actually being a mid-air. And the K50 is on fire. And not in a good way. Come on, Gazelle. Take a shot. Take a shot, brother. Make them count. Make them count. Hit him with a fucking... I think he's going down. No, this is still going to go on, guys. He's going to use the Squirrel Nation to help him. Pops out. Surprise, motherfucker. I was here all along. Oh, I took one of the wings off. Don't hit him, bro. Don't collide into him. Great fight. Great fight. My man Blade takes it. Oh, is he going to crash? Watch those squirrels, bro. No, he's recovered from that. Great fighting by Blade there. Good job, sir. Good job. Look how isolated he is as well. My man Feral Cat's in a bit of a Russian sandwich here. He has Chuga in the back, Shadow in the front, and Yukon coming in from the side. I don't think Yukon sees him yet. He's going to go right under him, left to right. He's heavy on the fucking guns in the K50 in front of him. Bro, that guy's way too far away, dude. What the fuck? Why, bro? You're just giving away your position, dude. Ah, he's excited. I'm not going to judge him, guys. He's excited. I would be excited too. Bro, you'll take a shot at him when he's 4 miles away, but you won't... Nah, I'm not going to judge him. I'm not judging him. There's another bus. I don't think that bus has seen us, though. No one sees us, guys. So you should switch targets. Fucking fuck the K50, bro. Stop shooting this guy. Mistakes were made, sir! God fucking damn it, dude, he's right there! Target fixation, brothers and sisters. Target fixation. Now the MIA's starting to sort on us in the back. My man Feral Cat, maybe just getting a little bit tunnel vision. I'm not judging him because he's a trained professional, but... Yeah, come on, motherfucker. Taw impact. Looks like shit's getting real for him. He's doing a good job of staying high, that MIA.
MAV X104TH Scottish MAV.
Hey, what's up, brother? Thanks for the re-up, Flying Finn. Thanks for the tier 1 for 8 months, dude. Thank you very much. Hope you're enjoying the stream, sir. Alright, who's impact sorting on? He's up here wheeling and dealing. He's got some good altitude. He doesn't really have anybody in front of him apart from Shadow. I don't think he sees. I don't think he's sorted on Shadow, though. Shadow looks like he's sorted on him. I don't think anybody's really going to get this guy at that altitude, though. This would be a great shot by Shadow. Shadow actually does connect a couple of shots there. There's some stuff coming off that aircraft. Holy fucking God, bro! Oh my fucking God! That was the shot of the tournament, guys. That was the fucking shot of the tournament. Good God. Down he fucking goes, brothers and sisters. He has a long way to go, but God damn, what a shot, dude. What a fucking shot. I just said, I don't think that guy's going to be touchable from up there as well. The guy's like, shut up, Maverick, you fucking noob. I'll take him out. Alright, Ross Pups has managed to contain his engine fire. And there goes another Hue. There's a lot of aircraft getting taken out, guys. This has been an expensive war. We need some fixed-wing air cover in here, guys. This is getting expensive. We're running out of airframes. Alright, Bullet's trying to take down fucking Shadow. I'm not sure if I would go near this guy. This is fucking Sniper Steve over here. This was the bro that fucking took out that high altitude gazelle. God damn, what a shot that was. What a shot. Alright, Thompson looks like he might be trying to reinforce stuff. I'm not sure what Camino's doing. Camino looks like he is lost in the trees. Camino is waiting. Camino's in no rush. Tiger's going to be facing off with Crash. We have another merge here between Blade and Cafartes. That guy. And it looks like Calf. We'll just call him Calf from now on, guys. It looks like Calf has a little bit of damage and he's electing to try and get out of there. And Blade might want to try and run him down. He's going to transfer this airspeed into Nose Authority and maybe take some shots up the way, I'd think. I would go for it, bro. Get in. He's not going to go for it. He's too low now. Watch the fucking squirrels, bro. Watch the squirrels, bro! Holy shit, dude. They'll get you. They'll get you. Don't disrespect the squirrels, guys. Alright, Tiger going to be trying to run down RF21939. Old Calf is YOLOing straight over Blade, who should still be lower than him. Where is he? Yeah, he's down there. Blade electing to come up now. He try and get some altitude so he can be a bit more aggressive with the nose and not worry about hitting the squirrels or the squirrels hitting him. It's like Calf's electing now to take the fight down low and lose that altitude advantage that he had. I maybe just be wanting to transfer all this altitude into airspeed and just get the fuck out. I'd maybe bring your landing gear up, bro. That would maybe just... it's not going to make a huge difference, but it'll definitely help get you out of there. Alright, Blade's now finding himself in a bit of a Stalin sandwich here. He's got a K-50 in front, which he's trying to run down, but he has an MIA of RF21939. Trying to run him down. It looks like our man Calf did actually get shot down by Blade. So we've seen Blade take some more aircraft out. He's just put another notch on his bedpost. RF21939 is going to try and make him pay, though. The flight model's a little questionable on that Gazelle, though, so he's able to just zip right round him. No fucks given. And it looks like Blade is going to come back and try and run this guy down. So RF access, two Gazelles trying to take him down now. There's fucking Maverick and Iceman in the back here. And we're on fire. We are on fire, guys. And that sounds like an engine that has given up the ghost. Oh, and he makes it. He fucking makes it, guys. Are they going to show any mercy? Are they going to kill themselves? Mercy might be shown, guys. It looks like they're showing mercy. They're going to allow him to get out and go and see his family, live to fight another day. Holy shit, there's a lot of stuff happening over here. We've got Chuga Yambo and Night Stalker. Night Stalker looks like he is... Holy fuck, it looks like he's taking a lot of damage, bro. That's what it looks like. His ground... His side door gunners are trying to attack the enemy ground troops. He's trying to keep them... He's trying to give them the angle to make sure that can keep happening. However, the problem is we are being shot at by a fucking Soviet bus, bro. We might want to do something about this guy. Holy shit, these side door gunners are... Oh my god, bro, he should be dead. He should be dead, dude. That much lead into the cockpit. There's no way he's... There's no way you're surviving that. Oh, the side door gunners, guys. Playing an awesome... he's dead. He is going down, bro. Oh, but unfortunately, we don't... Oh, not the tail rotor checked out. The main rotor checked out. Apologies, guys. I'm afraid we need that. God damn it. In we go. In we go. Alright, Yambo looks like he's trying to extend away from Neo CB. We have a merge here. We've got Tiger and Requiem merged. Requiem doing a good job of just staying in the hover and just rotating the nose round to get the nose authority for the shot. Needs to be careful for the Squirrel Nation, though. He has taken a little bit out of Tiger. Tiger may be YOLOing straight in the trees. Oh, up, jump, up. And he's dead. Never mind. Never mind. He's got the Eye of the Tiger. It is down there somewhere in that forest, so he'll get it back. He'll pick up that Eye of the Tiger and get back in. Yambo in a decent little merge here. Who'll be fighting against Yambo and NeoCB/Chris? Right, Yambo. Chris definitely in the driving seat. Has a good look down, shoot down opportunity here. Yambo, I think, has totally lost sight on him. Doesn't know where he is, so he's waiting to get shot at to try and work out where his opponent is. Oh, and he takes a taste. That was a great little shot there by Chris. Nice one, dude. And another one, sir. Well done. Fucking hell.
Affirmative.
Oh, good hits. Great hits. Right, Yambo's going to get out of there. We know this guy's got the luck of the Irish. You You need to get some lottery tickets on, Yambo. We always see lots of bad stuff happen to you, dude, and somehow you always manage to survive. I love this guy. He's still in trouble, though. Chris is closing down. He's done a good job of keeping his altitude. He's not been too greedy and just sort of traded all the altitude for airspeed. Yambo looks like he is coming up to meet him. He's probably got a shout by the fighter controller to say, hey, bro, he's fucking behind you and he's higher. Someone else is shooting at us as well. Holy shit, shit's getting real. He can only shoot at one at a time. Holy fuck, dude, he totally no-scopes the fucking other one. This guy, Yambo, bro, I swear to God, dude. This guy's not even human. Oh, and he's going to magically just use the force to kill the other one. He's going to come back towards camera. That's a great shot, dude. He fucking killed the other one, guy. This guy, ladies and gentlemen. This fucking guy. What a legend. What a legend. Right, what else is happening? Right, the blue side look like they're making a big push on Objective Charlie here. Is that Charlie? Alpha Bravo Charlie. Yep, so we do have some enemy ground troops close to. We do have some blue ground troops up there as well. Possibly going to see a little bit of ground infantry combat. Why are you guys not shooting at each other? I see you, bro. I see you. Enemy spotted, dude. Have you not got line of sight on this guy? What is he? Just peeking. He's a little peeker. We're getting engaged, bro. Shit's getting real. Oh, he's dead. I was going to say, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. If you ever find yourself in a combat zone and you've got side door gunners shooting at you, the best thing you can do is just stay still. They got him eventually. Accuracy by volume, guys. That's what it's all about. Accuracy by volume. Just fucking keep shooting until you hit something. Bullets trying to run down Frosty. He definitely sees him. Watch out for those squirrels, Bullet. Don't let it happen, sir. Frosty's trying to get on the sneak. Bullet will not allow that to happen. Needs to go a little bit more lead pursuit, I think, Bullet. We see him going right to left, bro. Let's get a little bit more left pedal in there. Let's go lead. I think he hears me through the force. Why are both these things happening? Holy shit, he's going down, dude. What the fuck? What happened? What's happening to my voice? What happened to my voice, guys? No one was even fucking near him. No one was even fucking near him. He just popped out some flares and then... There's no way Bullet hit him. Did he? I'm not sure what happened here. I think the aliens got him. Must have been the aliens, guys. Only reasonable answer that I can conclude is that it was aliens. Alright, Bullet has turned back around. He's got 2K50s off the nose. This could be risky. They are both trying to sort on quad, though. So he might get a little ambush opportunity here. They are taking long... This is what I'm saying, guys. Stop with the fucking long shots, brothers and sisters. All you're doing is giving your position away. And Bullet gets some good hits on. Some great hits, in fact. The K50s just don't give a fuck. They're both still target fixated on the same guy. Oh, bro, look how many hits that is. Look how many hits that is, dude. K50 is A-okay, though. Looks like he's going to just keep going after the guy. So he had good airspeed in that direction. So rather than loop back round and try and hit him, he's elected to try and chase this guy down. However, we do have someone shooting at us in the back. I think it's a guy's wingman. Where are we getting shot from? So Bullet is going to come around and try and address the threat at 6. Has decided that, hey, I've got more chance of probably getting merged with the guy behind me chasing me than the guy in front of me trying to run away. Sensible decision. He's coming, but he's bringing the pain early. Accuracy by major volume here. That must be so intimidating as a K-50 pilot, seeing that fucking Wally red rice coming at you, so... Some great sounds. So Bullet has the altitude, so the K-50 driver needs to put his nose up to hit him. That's going to mean that he's going to end up sliding backwards and losing altitude eventually, but some great fucking accuracy by this K50 driver. Takes the tail rotor and the main rotor off, bro. Holy shit. Who was that? That was a great kill. That was, I think that was Requiem. Or it may have been Yambo. I think the scoreboard's still fucked up. Yambo isn't anywhere near here. So it wasn't actually Yambo. I think it was Requiem, guys. I think it was Requiem. We'll check in attack view after that. Board is in all sorts of trouble. Look at this guy in the middle of Missy, Camino, Harley, Feral Cat, and Alpha Fox Alpha. Someone's shooting at us from way up top. It's a huge... Holy shit, bro. That's an aggressive move.
Son, your ego is writing checks your body can't cash.
Seen that coming. Alright, unfortunately that did not pay off. Right, so the Blues are well in control of this objective now. Just need to kill one more soldier. He's hiding down there somewhere. I'm not sure where he is. He may actually be in... Oh, he's actually outside of the compound. Here he is, here he is. Oh, he's inside a building. There's two of them. Oh, there's three of them! Fucking hell, there's a whole fucking... Oh, these are British guys. British. Never mind. I'm not sure what happened there. He just got killed. Just as I clicked on him, he got killed. So the red side are trying to do the same thing at Objective Echo. And I think Tom Ago is trying to come in and stop that from happening. Quad G is heading out of the area. He might have bitten off a little bit more than he can chew. He sees that there's four enemy aircraft down there. He thinks a little bit better of it. But Tom Ago is going to try and come in there. He's going to grab his balls and get in there. He's like, fuck it, bro, I'll get in there. Let me at him, coach. So we can see two aircraft that have more altitude than us. Two K-50s heading north, heading away. Is he going to go after those, or is he going to... Ah, bro, I would maybe go towards the objective. Look, there's a bus sitting there on his own. You've got the ground troops there as well. Why go after the fighters when you can go after the bomber? Hey, I'm not judging him. I'm not judging him. Alright. 104 Cadet Eons looks like he's going to try and run down Harley, who's right off his nose now. Oh, they're gun pods. They're not fuel pods. They're actually more gun pods. So the Eons just need to be a bit patient here. Take a shot. He's not under any real danger from anybody else, I don't think. So stick with this for a little minute, see how this works out. So far, Harley doing a great job of staying out of trouble. Oh, some good accuracy there. Looks like he's got two sets of guns, both aiming in different directions, and shit, just there, shit got real, real fast. Oh, there's a gazelle off the left. Eons is in trouble. He does not see this gazelle. Who is it? It's Camino. We've seen Camino have some really good helicopter events before in the past. He's a great helicopter pilot. So Eons could be in a bit of trouble here. If Camino doesn't give up the ghost and stays with him, he might be in a bit of trouble. But I think the K-50 is actually just a little bit faster than the Gazelle. So I think if Eons wants to leave, Eons will be able to do so. Camino needs to be careful because Eons is heading along this valley towards two friendly buses from the Ugly Angel Squadron that are inbound. Mago is still pressing, so he did elect to drop the North Group. It looks like one guy from the North Group came back. Our man BSD Dutch, he actually elected to come back and try and defend this position. Not sure what Cathartis is doing. Is he maybe looking for his gun? His cannon's looking all the way down, so I think he's trying to hunt the enemy ground units. That's exactly what he's doing. So he's using his camera and his sensor in the cockpit there to find the enemy troops that are on the ground and take them out. There's 30 minutes left. 30 minutes left. Here's my go and Dutch. It looks like Dutch has got the energy to get away from this, I think. All he needs to do is just, yeah, put his nose down and leave. I don't think that gazelle is going to catch him. And it looks like Calf has done a great job at pretty much sanitizing the area. Blue troops, there is three of them left, so... But those guys are all hiding around that building that we seen earlier on when I was pressing F7, so I don't think he's going to see them from that position. He's going to have to rotate around to the other side of that objective to be able to get line of sight on those guys. We have Requiem, quite isolated, just to the east of Bullseye, 3 miles. And it looks like Havco, who had a great F-15 event yesterday. This is the guy that came third place in the Top Gun Golden Eagle competition that we had yesterday, the F-15 guns only competition. So Havco, no stranger to being a finalist. Doesn't look like these guys have line of sight on each other just yet, though. Shit's going to get real, real soon, though. Surprise, motherfucker! Oh, some great shots there. Some great shots by the K50 driver, who I've totally forgotten who it is already. It is Requiem. Here's a good kill opportunity. Oh, dude, that's bad. That's real bad. That is real bad, guys. Oh, the door gunner, bro! Shoot him, door gunner! What the fuck? God damn it, Jeff. I wonder if that door gunner got killed there, because that was a huge kill opportunity. Down he goes. Good kill for the Queen. Well done, sir. Alright, McGoo getting really fucking aggressive here. He's going up against 3 enemy aircraft over Objective Delta, and he's got 2 enemy aircraft over to his north. Eons and Camino did actually end up merged. Looks like Camino in the driving seat so far. Eons with some heavy fucking aggression on the nose. And he managed to, he did soak up a lot, he did take a bit of hits there, but I think he managed to avoid the worst of the trouble. Maybe thinking about leaving the fight now. Probably the sensible idea. Camino on the reset in the back, trying to run him down. Alright, McGo has a lot of enemy aircraft around him, none of which see him. I think that MI8 maybe sees us, actually. But he's definitely targeting on this K50. Wants a taste of this guy. We're doing the salmon. Take your time, dude, take your time. Great hits. Nice, nice. Let's make it count, bro. I know I said take your time, but we sort of have to hurry up as well, dude. There's a lot of them around here. Finish him, brother. Finish him.
Tufty.
Get him. Shoot him. There's a fire on the port side. Shit's getting real. His wingman looks like a bus coming to the rescue, I think. No, it's another K50. Oh, that one. So that one's dead. So yeah, he gets a good little kill there. Good cheeky kill, but now he's got some serious problems coming in fast. The K50 driver overshoots. So where is he? It's my goal. So it looks like that was Dutch coming in to try and take a bit of pressure off. Grizzly's going to just looks like wants to stand down back to the objective. And looks like Crash is touching down to deploy some more troops. Crashes safely down. So he's going to get even more troops on the ground to make it even more difficult for the blue side to take control of this objective. So that's some, and we have a Ugly Angel Grizzly coming in to support him as well and drop off some more guys. What else is going on? Do we have any PvP? Holy fuck! Black Pixel is in a world of fucking trouble, guys. He is way too deep. If he gets any further north, he's
going. Hey, bud, thanks for swinging through my stream last night. Tactic 104, Tactic Pew.
Thank you very much, sir. You are very welcome. Tactical Pete, thanks for the re-up, sir, on the tier 1 for 2 months. You're very welcome, sir. Hope you had a great stream. But yeah, Black Pixel, like I said, he said he was in deep trouble. He's fucking fine, bro. He needs to be careful he doesn't get too close to these Vulcans or he will be in big trouble. But I don't know where. What's this guy's plan? Where could this guy possibly be going? He may be going back to Moscow or something. How far away is Moscow, bro? Moscow is pretty far away. I'm not sure if he's got the fuel to get to Moscow. Where could this guy possibly be going? Here's his closest objectives over here, Alpha, Bravo and Charlie. I don't know what the plan is from Black Pixel, dude. Is he sightseeing? Is this a tourist thing? Not sure what's going on, guys. Not sure what's going on. Right, Mago is trying to run down Dutch. Mago, it might be. Might not be Mago. Maybe Mago, I'm not sure. I am not sure. Alright, we have some red ground troops making their way towards objective Delta, which is pretty cool. That's pretty gangster. Those guys are actually just YOLOing in on foot. Look at these guys. Holy shit, what the fuck, Wax? Come on, son! Fuck's sake! Alright, is Camino going to be able to sort on the fucking the alien troops? Where are they? Oh, they're engaging them! Look at that, bro! Alright, Wags, I take that back. That's cool as fuck. Those guys can keep crawling on their knees if they want. Oh shit, they shot him down, dude! They got shot down by fuck off, bro! That's a bad day out. That's a bad day out. Camino absolutely been wrecking people all fucking event. Gets taken down by five bros on their... Five bros with fucking skint knees took him down, bro. Fuck's sake. That is a bad day in the office, guys. Alright, Mago is creeping up into this objective. I don't think anyone sees him just yet. Fucking taking out the game with fucking five bros with sore knees, brothers and sisters. Fuck's sake. Alright, Eons looks like he is trying to sort on these infantry troops here. Has no idea that Tom Mago is kicking around. This guy fucking needs to change his name. This should be Magoo. Come on, bro. Come work with me, son. I hate this fucking name. So Eons looks like he's trying to get visual. Yeah, he's engaging these troops now, but there's the fucking bro. I think he's just seen him as well. Yeah, he's just seen him, but Eons doesn't know he's there. He might be getting a call now, though. Yep, they definitely know each other there now. Look at Eon's aircraft. Looks like Swiss cheese, dude. There's a lot of holes in that. More holes than a prostitute's tights. Right, both pilots scrambling for altitude a little bit here. Trying to get the advantage. Old Mr. Magoo's doing a good job at fucking just keeping on top of things. Nice little snapshot opportunity here. Trades his position for a little snap, a little taste, a little tickle. Eons has got a chance to get his nose on and get some shots out here. That Gazelle is just too maneuverable, I think, though. Doing a great job of getting out of the way. Does he have any backup? No, it's kind of just these two. In fact, there's a lot of backup coming for the red side. Thompson and Pups are going to end up merged as well. They're going to YOLO right past each other. Oh, look at look at that maneuvering from the UH-1H in the background there. Obviously listening to the Vietnam soundtrack, and he wants to get some. And the bus driven by Pups with a very lazy left turn. Ah, he's not in too much of a hurry. And a long range effort by the Huey driver on the Stalin bus. He has taken some hits out of him. Oh fuck, there's another one right in front of him, dude. Shoot that guy! Who are we watching here? Alright, so it's Thompson. Holy shit, Thompson, some great hits, bro. Great hits, but maybe shoot at this guy, dude. Ah, he snuck in. This guy snuck in, he's getting his troops off. Someone's shooting at him, though. I think that's the enemy ground troops are shooting him again. These fucking enemy ground troops, bro, are not to be messed with. Holy fuck! Taken out the game, sir. Oh, a K50 cannon is so dangerous, bro. If they sneak up on you, dude, you're in so much trouble. Here's Blade. We've seen Blade get some great kills already. And again, this cannon is not to be trifled with either. The cannon on this Gazelle is pretty fucking scary, guys. Although the Soviet bus is... Oh, never mind, never mind. We sort of need the back of it, bro. Oh, dude, that would be a terrifying position to be in real life. Never mind, I don't want to see that, bro. That's bringing back some bad thoughts there. Alright, so it looks like Alpha Fox Alpha is the only blue pilot defending this area. So I take that back. Harley Nick is inbound from the north to try and give his bro some mutual support. But dude, this is an uphill battle. There's fucking red aircraft everywhere. There is one blue bro on the ground down there. He's surviving. He's wheeling and dealing. Oh, this is bad. I don't think he sees this guy. Oh, I saw him maneuvering out the way. Maybe he does see him then. But yeah, this guy's in a world of pain. A world of pain. It looks like he's sorting on this K50 in front of us. Oh, that's a bus, actually, that's trying to get out of here. Oh, there was some massive calamity in the background there. I'm not sure what happened there. I think that was two aircraft colliding with each other. We just missed that. This K50 is still perching up. He's trying to do the old eagle maneuver. You're goddamn right, that was an eagle sound effect, guys. Alpha Fox Alpha in a bit of trouble here. He's sort of just putting himself on a plate for this guy right in front of him. Well, that's a big hit, that's a big connection. This K50 driver sliding straight into these DMs, bro. Alpha doing a great job of getting out the way. I mean, he's not really that fast here, but he's just doing a fantastic job of getting out of the way, but I'm afraid this is more or less inevitable, guys. We're on fire, and not in a good way. Down he goes. YOLO'd straight into a hospital for the elderly, guys. God damn it, never mind. Alright, here comes Bullet creeping up. Bullet's on the creep in a fantastic looking aircraft. Look at this, Air America! I'm sure that's the CIA, is it not? Oh, my back. Posture, Maverick. Posture. That's how you got in this fucking situation in the first place. Alright, so no one seems to be sorted on Bullet. He's just sort of YOLOing along. Sunshine, lollipops and rainbows. Everything is wonderful is what I feel when we're together. That's what's on the in-flight PA at the moment in Bullet's aircraft. He's just YOLOing along. No worries from a man Bullet so far. Just YOLO'd right literally in the middle of fucking everyone. No fucks given. He's going to go straight in there. Now, he needs to be careful because we've seen these enemy ground troops, bro. They're fucking pretty deadly. Are they doing the moonwalk? We've got some more Michael Jacksons coming, guys, for fuck's sake. Bullet's going to probably start sorting on these guys. Just getting in with the cannons. Case. That's enough, Mike. Thanks. All right, so Bullet is running down with some gun runs on the Michael Jackson fan club here, the Jackson 5. Oh, and Bullets get taken down! Billie Jean shoots him in the fucking face, bro! Bullet walked into Neverland dressed as a child. Paid the price. Alright, looks like Eons is trying to sort on the blue Jackson 5 up here. It's the Jackson 2, actually. Putting some rounds downrange. Takes out one! I think he killed them both. Rest in peace. So Eon's doing a good job on the sanitize. Sanitizes Maximus. Right, so Alpha belongs to Blue. Bravo belongs to Blue. Charlie did belong to Blue, but then Eon sanitized that. Delta is in firm red hands, and it looks like Blue are still in control. Blue have got more guys down than Echo than the red guys. Here we have Brown Floyd. Let's see what this guy's done. Where's the... So he's hoping that his ground troops... Sorry, his side door gunners are going to start engaging these enemy ground troops. There's 15 minutes in the event left. And it looks like they are doing a good job. He is taking down... Those guys are engaging stuff. We've got another wingman somewhere shooting at people coming in from the side. There he is. There's a K50. Just putting some rounds into the area. Probably using his camera and stuff like that. There's only one Michael Jackson bro left here. Oh, no, he's up on his feet. Look at this guy getting up and getting on. I love this guy. He's not a handsome guy, but hey, I'm not judging him. He looks like a man of few words. This guy's right in the danger zone, bro. You're a bad place, bro. We need to fucking find some cover. The enemy are fucking everywhere, bro. Let's go! Fucking bob! Dive, dip, slip, bro. Keep moving, dude. You better keep it moving, cuz stuff's gonna get real bad here. So long, sir. So long. Your story will be told. Alright, so Red have totally sanitized this area now. We need to get Pups in. Is Pups going to land with some ground troops? Or has he already done that and has none left now? So it looks like he is not landing. So I don't think Pups actually has any ground troops on Brown. Floyd maybe doesn't have anybody either because he doesn't look like he's trying to land. So we need to very quickly get a Soviet bus over here as fast as we can. It looks like it's going to be Grizzly from the Ugly Angel Squadron. He might be coming with some peeps. Let's go with the peeps, bro. Get those peeps in there. Right. What else is happening? What else is happening? Black Pixel looks like he has finished on his sightseeing tour and is getting into the fight now. I think we're trying to sanitize. Where are we? This is Objective Bravo. So, yeah, Blue Side done a great job of getting a lot of troops on the ground, but then I've totally neglected them. They haven't actually protected them. Although these blue guys, the Jackson 5 here are doing a great job at engaging Eons. Look how many fucking hits he's taking, god damn. Bro, you need to fire back. Dude, don't land now, we're under fire, sir. There's the enemy troops up there, so he needs to block line of sight to get his troops off. And it looks like we're going to have a bit of a firefight on the go. So Black Pixel is touching down. I need to check TeamSpeak, hold on. Some fucking guy, can I join the event? No bro, it started an hour and a half ago. Fucking. Alright, this could be good. This could be good. We can maybe see some infantry combat here, guys. They don't have line of sight. This is like the Mexican standoff here. Look at this. Look, so here's all the enemy troops right here. Michael Jackson again. This guy just can't stop moving those feet, bro. Can't stop it. There's no stopping him. It's all quiet on the Western Front. Maybe they've signed a truce. Maybe there's some kind of truce going on, guys, and they've decided not to. Oh shit, Ugly Angel Thompson's coming in. He needs to be careful though, because there's a lot of red troops on the ground now. And we've seen before, guys, that these guys are not to be messed with. Any PvP happening? Nope. So Thompson coming in with a gun. Yeah, there's a lot of enemy troops still down there for Dobson to engage. This is where he needs to be careful. The Jackson 5 will get him if he gets too slow. I need to try and track IR on, bro. Oh, there it is. They're doing the Michael Jackson. Oh, he's doing the Michael Jackson. Oh, and he's dead. And he's dead. God damn it, Mike. Where were you, bro? Where were you, Mike? Where were you when they needed you? Holy shit, dude. Things have escalated. That's the blue troops engaging that MI8, guys. Holy fuck, bro. Who else is shooting him? That's another. That's a double team with a Huey. No mercy. Oh, we're shooting our own troops, bro. Be careful. Thompson. maybe needs to go to the range and work on the accuracy a little bit, Thompson. But yeah, don't get me wrong, sir. You're doing a great job. You're doing a great job. I think most of the blue troops have been killed by a friendly helicopter, though. And we've got some more Russian troops on the ground, guys. Thompson going to get his troops out. Fuck, this guy is a multitasking genius. We are being engaged. Long range by a K-50 Stranger. Get those troops out, brother, and get up. Troops are out. Run, troop guys, run. Ah, oh, Thompson. Thompson, no!
Negatory.
God damn it. That is all kicking off around about this objective, guys. Good God, this is awesome. So Crash is still on the ground. So he's not going to be able to trim that out. And here comes a Huey coming to really put the pain in, really put the nail in the coffin. God damn it, where's the mercy, guys? Where is the mercy? Holy shit, son. God damn it, I can't even watch, guys. So there's no red troops left anywhere. All the red troops are now dead. It's just a blue affair. We've got Missy merging with RF 21939. Dutch is sorting right on his 6-0 hist. Don't let it happen, Missy! Don't let it happen, bro! Oh, he's going to know that K-50's there now. Yep. Move, bro. Move, Bob. Slip. Fucking get the guns up, bro. Get the guns up. Let him have it! Holy shit! Missy doing a great job of staying fast and maintaining that energy to stay out of the way. Well flown, sir. Well flown. He's got Dutch still trying to rate him round, and our man Calf is the guy that nearly flew into us. He's trying to help him out as well. We've got Feral trying to gun down Frosty. Come on, Feral. Let's get some shots in there, bro. Doesn't get any better than this, dude. Doesn't get any better than this. Come on, son. Reset the trim, bro. You see him doing the salmon? He's sort of wobbling around. Needs to, bro, we must be out of ammo or something. What the fuck? He's right there, dude.
Enemy helicopter spotted.
Fucking right there, fam. Look at that ass. Holy shit, there's a wee guy shooting at us at the back there. Look at that. That's fucking... That was a maneuver. That was a fucking maneuver. Nice one, Frosty. Why is Feral not shooting at this guy? I think Feral's just decided, you know what, bro? I'm sick of all this. Why can't we be friends? Yep. And now he's flying over the enemy ground troops, I think, and they are absolutely kicking... No. Yeah, that's enemy ground troops. Bro, these fucking enemy ground troops are OP as fuck. RF 21939. Coming into land, surrounded by enemy troops. I'm not sure how good an idea this is, sir. This is a hot LZ. Bro, I wouldn't even land here fucking flying in armor. He's done a good job though, he's got his troops off. I think the aircraft's fucked. Yep, that engine is spooling down, bro. Holy shit, dude, they killed a lot of the ground troops. There's still a little Jackson 6 up there. Holy shit, there's a lot of blue ground troops up there as well, god damn. This could be another epic battle, guys, another epic battle. But yeah, that bus is out of action, I'm afraid. No, sorry, no longer in service. Red side are swarming around here. There's one little blue bro on his own. Where are you, bro? Where are you, fam? Just got taken the fuck out. Someone just YOLO'd straight into him. Rest in peace. Rest in peace, bro. Right. Fucking hell. Maybe I can take a bit of a breather. Get some water in. Alright, Yukon has managed to sneak past everyone, unseen. And it looks like he's going to start trying to take out the enemy infantry up at Objective Alpha. There's only 5 minutes left in the match. So, yeah, guys, it really looked like Blue were in control. It looked like this was all about the Blue side to start off with. But Red have turned that frown upside down, guys, with some good teamwork and some good coordination. And some good cap presence as well from the attack pilots. A bit of a Mexican standoff here. These guys are not really engaging each other. That would have been cool to see a little bit of ground warfare. Doesn't look like that's going to happen, though. Where are these guys at? So there's the red guys. Where's the blue guys? Am I looking at the wrong place? Red guys. Blue guys. Look at that! Ah, oh, dude, you couldn't make this shit up. Well, that's why they're in the infantry. No offence. I know I just triggered somebody there. No offence, guys. Camino trying to run down Dutch. Holy shit, son. Stuff's happening. Who are you shooting at, bro? Maybe try to take out the squirrels. Oh shit, he's actually trying to take a little pip at the Huey in front of us. Camino's trying to rescue him. Camino with some great shots on target. Oh, Camino's really good with this gun, guys. It's like watching Octopo fire. But to be fair to the K50 driver, he's doing a good job at A, shooting the guy he's chasing, and B, staying out of the way of Camino. Oh, he's got some good hits on that Huey now, though. The Huey's in trouble. All three pilots doing a really good job here, I think. Look at the ground troops. He's flying too close to the red ground troops, and they're now engaging him. This gazelle needs to be careful as well. He's going to take some fire from the right hand side, I think. These guys on this hill should start shooting at him. The Huey is smoking. Come on, Camino, get in there, dude. Might be a better idea rather than try and use your nose to aim. Holy fuck, I need shot because I don't know what I'm fucking talking about. He takes him down from range, bro. Awesome. Takes him down from range. What a shot. I was just about to say, maybe be a better idea to rather than try and like use your nose to shoot him. Fucking just put the nose down and try and close the range down, dude. Get closer to him and then shoot him. But he was like, fuck that, Maverick. I'll just shoot him from half a mile away, bro. Half a mile away. Quad has landed on the roof and he's not been engaged by the enemy ground units that are right fucking there, bro. These are Russian special forces. Unfortunately, not special in a good way, though. Oh, we do have a little bit of ground warfare. A couple of blue troops have been killed. The Russian special forces did actually manage to kill some guys there. That was cool. He's doing the Michael Jackson, trying to just see if he can get around there and flank around and get on someone else. Are any blue troops moving towards him? This guy's sort of thinking about running right here, but he's sort of stopped. Not a lot's developing there. Eon's coming in to try and support his ground troops, so there is three American. Look how fast Eon's is arriving, bro. God damn. Where's this guy come? What's he got? Fucking jet wings. Blue ground troops are engaging him. Now, should be able to get shots on here. They're on the left hand side of the smoke here, right in front of him. They're probably going to start shooting at him again. We can see them, look, they're just moving down there. He's taking a knee. He's going to, yep. So Eons is going to, there's only one of those guys left, so Eons is going to get that all soaked up and mopped up. So Camino, looks like he may be trying to engage this little group up here. Is this the Jackson 123456? Here they come again, guys. God damn it. Get it sorted, Wags. Fuck's sake, brother. Alright, Camino looks like he might be trying to get himself in a bit of a hover position to sort out on those guys once he gets a little bit closer. Or is he on the ground? In fact, Camino is not in a position to do anything. Camino has seen better days. He's now thinking about his family. He's thinking about what he's going to do in retirement, thinking about where he's going to settle down. Here comes the man, the myth, the legend, Missy, to come and turn that frown upside down. There is no PvP happening right now, so we'll stay on board with Missy. Missy bringing the pain in a fucking heavy way, dude. Who are we shooting at? We're shooting at the Jackson 6. We are indeed. There's a Jackson 6 down there, guys. They're in big trouble. Missy's door gunner's doing a great job. He needs to just sort of get himself in a bit of an orbit now, just to steady out, because he can't get too close to these ground troops, or they're going to really ruin his day, which they're in the process of doing. Missy's in big trouble, taking some serious hits. And Eons and Shadow are extending away from him. And look, there we go, there's a message saying that the event's over. Thanks for participating. That was... God damn, guys, it's over. Thank God. Oh, bro. My throat is killing me now, dude. But this was a lot of fun, guys. This was a lot of fun to watch. I really enjoyed this. This was a good one. I think we're actually going to do this next month as well, I think, because of the old COVID-19. I think everybody's going to be taking time off work and all that stuff. And yeah, there's going to be a lot of people stuck in the house gaming. So I think the plan, I can't promise anything, guys, but the plan at the moment, as far as I'm aware, the plan is that we're going to do another event next month. So make sure you check the tournament section of ED Forums. So I'll post a link for where you can get information about what this one was. So if you don't have an account on ED Forums, get yourself signed up and registered, guys, and keep an eye on the tournament section of ED Forums. That's where all these sort of events get posted, including the red flag events that the 104th host, and any sort of other events that we're running are always posted in that the tournament section. But yeah, it looks like that's it, guys. I think most of the people have managed to make it back to base and land. So we'll hit up the ready room. Daniel NL, thanks for the follow, dude. Welcome, my man Bullet. Thanks for the raid. Tactical Pete, shout out again to Tactical Pete 44. Thanks for the tier 1 for the 2 months, dude. Mel 12345, thanks for the follow. Welcome on board, sir. The Flying Finn, thanks for the re-up for the tier 1 8 months, dude. Thank you very much. Tangra, thank you for the follow, sir. Welcome on board. I Am Box has also followed. Welcome. Demon MIT number 1, thanks for the raid, sir, and your support. El Gargantuan, thanks for the re-up on the Prime for 2 months. My man Skipster DC is coming in with a Prime again for 9 months as well. Thank you very much, dude. Death Dealer 1960, thank you for the follow. Wayhoo 1, thanks for the follow. My man Dicktron Never Carry, thanks for the follow, sir. Wins the award for the best name on Twitch so far today. Pac-Man 777, thanks for the follow. Joshua 5658, thanks for the follow, sir. And Deviator _, thank you for the follow, sir. Welcome on board, guys. Welcome on board. This was a good one. This was a good one. But that's going to do it for today. I am going to go and cry in the shower for a little while and then get to work and see what's happening on a debrief here. I will see you guys for the next one. Just quickly before I go, if any of you guys are an aspiring F-16 pilot, we're next month we are running Top Gun Viper Sniper. So it's a guns only event for the F-16. 1v1 guns only. So if you want to get involved, sign up on that link and we'll see you strutting your stuff next month, guys. Shout out to Alpenwolf, thank you so much for setting up this event. Thanks to 104th Tiger for helping me get the TeamSpeak channels, and thanks to everybody that took part and flew in the event and helped out with the GCI, and thanks to you guys for watching at home. Top Gun and Volleyball, I'll see you next time. Maverick out.